Welcome, you're watching the Thrift Store Rundown, I believe we're not even home on a budget. And as you already heard, all this week, we're using the power of variety to spice up your life. Or at least your winter, in varying heat levels ranging from moderately spiced to seriously sizzling. Yet I believe that entire range of temperatures will be all encompassed in this cookbook to start with. We start every week off with a cookbook review, you know that. And if you know me well, it's an even better start to the weekend or week ahead when it's an America's Test Kitchen cookbook review, particularly one that is oh so spiced. This offering unlocks the power of spices to transform your cooking, all in my case anyway, for $3.99. As you can tell by looking at the cover, this goes far beyond your handy conventional salt and pepper, even though that's going to be the focal point of today's video. Why? Because my reviews will range again from moderately spiced to seriously scorching in various fun and unexpected ways. So as we begin, I thought we'd add a side of caution and show you how to put the two most common seasonings in your household, salt and pepper, to better use. Before we take a look at this through my lens, let's first have a look at the inside through ATK's lens. So now that you know what you're getting yourself into, let's heat it up by seasoning smarter and getting more out of salt and pepper. You simply can't cook without S&P. These two most basic spices are the keys to making food taste like its best self. They're the yin and yang of seasoning. Salt isn't just a fine table stuff in the shaker, although that's certainly an important staple used throughout our recipes, and peppercorns aren't just the bitey jet black ones. No, there's a world of salt and pepper, a variety of salt green sizes, a rainbow of peppercorn colors to add to food before cooking, or a sprinkle on to finish dishes before serving for a flavorful touch. And in addition to flavor, salted large flakes or crushed peppercorns can add appealing texture and crunch you don't get from fine grained table spices. Broaden your salt and pepper horizons. We have here a guide to flavored salts, 5 homemade flavored salts using other combinations of seasonings with a tablespoon or teaspoon of kosher salt. These flavored salts can come in handy for the dishes that follow. After a guide to the variety of sea salt you might find on the market. And pepper. So here we have a radish baguette with chive butter and salt which serves 8 to 12. A wedge salad with creamy black pepper dressing. In this case, you'll be using salt and coarse ground pepper to start with. A grilled chicken salad. So everyday run-of-the-mill stuff so far, but the spices make it also not run-of-the-mill. Pan-seared steaks with brandy pink peppercorn sauce, their homage to steak au poivre. Seared duck breast with green peppercorn sauce. And here we have one of several spiced four-way pizzas. This example of one master recipe and 3 spicy variations, a peppercorn-crusted beef tenderloin with hollandaise sauce. We also have pink peppercorn-crusted, white peppercorns, and green peppercorns, with sun-dried tomato hollandaise sauce for green, cilantro lime for pink, and tarragon for white peppercorn. All hollandaise sauces with varying colors of peppercorn, varying shades of pepper for the beef tenderloin. Moving on to thick-cut pork chops with smoked salt, pan roasted fish fillets with herb salt, spaghetti with pecorino romano and black pepper, and a guide to brining, an essential technique to learn for flavorful meats, like grilled roasted pork loin, plus pan-seared salmon with cilantro mint chutney. We also have crispy salt and pepper shrimp, a Chinese restaurant staple, if you're lucky enough to find it on a menu. Grilled brine carrots with cilantro yogurt sauce, a guide to salting it, again, vis-a-vis brining, an extra technique to prevent chalky, dried out meat. Crispy skinned chicken breast with lemon rosemary pan sauce, pictured right here alongside a salt baked whole branzino, salt baked, I should say, not braked. That would be breaking a baked fist. And I would say, if you're brave, you'd be more than happy to break into this. For several recipes, you'll find step-by-step photographic instructions for key techniques to master in them. That's pretty neat. Ingredient recommendations? Well, they come by way of different types of spices, dry and fresh, that you can find at the market. Equipment recommendations? Well, you got spice grinders and a saute pan for toasting some of the spices, another key technique to learn. Toasting spices, blooming them in hot skillets. Heat on heat action, folks, actually releases the fragrances and makes them even stronger. We also have here salt-crusted fingerling potatoes and a smashed cucumber salad. Buy one, grab. And finally, preserved lemons. Moroccans preserved lemons to show how transformative salt can be. Once preserved in salt, lemon becomes an almost completely different ingredient, an incredible, versatile condiment. Speaking of which, you'll learn how to utilize fresh and dry spices in homemade condiments, plus use them in compound butter, steep them in oil. The techniques go on and on and on. I'm stuttering because I'm actually salivating right now. Plus, as you know, spices aren't just used for savory applications. They can also be used for a wide variety of desserts. In fact, we have an entire section here going beyond vanilla, bringing sophisticated flavor to baked goods and desserts. You can also use mint and lavender. As a matter of fact, a few types of spices that this book will call for: ginger, cardamom, cinnamon, paprika, cayenne, and a type of ethnic chili pepper that's kind of paprika-ish, if I can find that for you. That would be called, and we do have a complete guide to spices in alphabetical order, A to Z, learning about the overall flavor, origin, and typical uses of spices that ETK commonly use in the recipes, as well as the spice blends in this book. Yes, we have a lot of homemade spice blends in here. That chili pepper I was talking about is called espalete. It's worth seeking out, often used as a condiment in the Basque region where it's grown. The spicy, fruity dried pepper contributes both warm heat and paprika-like sweetness to dishes. Paprika can certainly, easily be substituted. We also have here fennel, garlic powder, cumin, the works, even celery seed and cloves, and chili powder, and curry powder. Really, the list goes on and on, and so do the recipes. A wide variety of good-natured, well-rounded recipes in here. Bold flavors, yet mostly simple enough to prepare on a weeknight, yet dazzling enough for a weekend fare. All thanks to the power of spices. Really, every element of a proper ATK cookbook, at least one post Christopher Kimball, is present here, including nutritional stats and conversions and equivalents at the very tail end of it. With this book, you'll discover the many ways you can turn to spices to take your cooking to the next level. Once you've learned the simple techniques used around the world to unlock the flavors of spices, you'll be able to work intuitively with the contents of your spice cabinet to not only add proper seasoning to your dishes, but also bring them to life, adding flair and excitement to food every time you cook. With 139 foolproof recipes and 47 DIY spice blends and condiments, you'll take your food from simple to spectacular and spiced. You see the other recipes in here on the back cover, including a guide to making spice-infused oils. All this retailing for $29.99 US, $35 in Canada. Get a good shot of the light here because there's a lot of light to be found in here. You're gonna open your palate to a whole new world of flavor that's just sitting in your spice rack, waiting to be used up. Since every element of a good ATK cookbook is present here, it gets the full Monty. A perfect 5 claps. Spices are not meant to incinerate. They're meant to accelerate your passion for livelier home cooking. And this, my friends, is alive with the sounds of music for your brave, brave taste buds. All except one. Seriously, if you haven't watched that kids' cooking show, Taste Buds, back when it aired on Cuba on NBC stations on Saturday mornings, you haven't lived. watching TSR. Now, to see another awesome review like this one, click here. If you want to become a Hollywood bargain hunter, click here to subscribe. And I'll catch you on the thrift side.